The fact that there is one person preaching to you every Sunday is not biblical. It does not make the pastor accountable to others. It forms an autocracy, that is self-rule, because there are no other overseers. By the way, in the Bible, the word translated overseer also means pastor, also means a bishop, a presbyter. So it's all from that same word, and it really is about the same office in the church. Church passivity, that is non-action on the part of congregants, of church members. You know the old saying, you check your brain at the door, because people are just sitting there week in, week out, Sunday in, Sunday out, listening to one individual. That one individual, that pastor, will eventually burn out. We have seen it. I have seen it in my life with other pastors where they're just not being helped. There is no teamwork, so they quickly burn out. And obviously, there's no church edification. No one person has all the gifts, skills, and abilities that the congregation needs. You know, someone once said that the problem with churches are the people. You know, people need different things. And as your church group grows, as your membership grows, you will have more issues, more problems. So the one person cannot obviously meet all those different personalities and the problems they bring every Sunday morning. Now, the Bible does talk about pastors in the plural. It is biblical. Again, the word is presbyterios in the plural. 10 plus times it appears throughout the New Testament. It's used in the singular once, as far as I know, in 1 Timothy 5:19, and it has to do with accusations against an elder or a presbyter that requires two or three witnesses. So I found this fascinating that the one singular use of the word, translated pastor, bishop, has to do with the church holding them accountable, malpractice or bad action or bad teaching, perhaps. It creates a democracy, the right kind of democracy, by the way. We know that the world has, you know, perverted many words. But democracy, there is a good positive sense to it, and that is there are group decisions. You are sharing different gifts with your fellow pastors. There is obvious accountability. Proverbs 15:22. Without counsel, plans fail, but with many advisors, your plans will succeed. This is biblical, and it's really common sense. You don't really need to be a Christian, by the way, to understand that there is wisdom in seeking advice with others. You know the old saying, no man is an island. Now, some time ago, I created one of my first ever videos, and I checked the date. As you can see, this is a screen capture from our YouTube channel 10 years ago now. And unfortunately, it's a little scene video, only 257 views, 10 years, perhaps people can't find it. But I did this quick video, which I'd like to close with, and just to show you the gravity of this issue.
In the shoulder where I stand.
Jones said he stood for social and economic equality, a utopian society. He was politically active and something of a local celebrity. But after some negative publicity, Jones moved his church and his followers to Guyana.
March 19, 1997, and I'm Doe. some called our partnership T and Doe. That's not my name, but that's how I'm referred to on planet Earth. Let me say that our mission here at this time is about to come to a close in the next few days.